Would you please stand? Thank you. everybody, and welcome to this evening's carol service. Just a few words before we continue. Throughout the service, we will sit and stand at various points. If you could watch us and follow when we sit and when we stand. A reminder that we need to keep our masks on throughout the service, even when we are singing. Would you please sit or kneel for the opening prayer? Through the days of Advent, we have followed the light of Christ, and now we travel in spirit with Mary and Joseph to Bethlehem to acclaim with the multitude of the heavenly host the coming of the Prince of Peace. Through scripture and silence, prayer and song, let us hear again the wonderful story of our redemption, and hearing, let us rejoice and respond with lively faith. Almighty God, you make us glad with the yearly remembrance of the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that as we joyfully receive him as our Redeemer, we may with sure confidence behold him when he shall come to be our Judge, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. His name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. He shall feed his flock like a shepherd, and he shall gather the lambs with his arm. He shall carry them in his bosom, and gently lead those that are with you. We remain seated for our first carol.
Thank you.
Please sit for our first reading.
The birth of Jesus Christ, according to St. Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 25, and St. Luke chapter 2, verses 4 to 7. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child of the Holy Spirit. And her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. But as he considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took his wife, but knew her not until she bore a son. And Joseph went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And they called his name Jesus.
Thank you. The Oxen by Thomas Hardy. Christmas Eve and 12 of the clock. Now they are all on their knees, an elder said, as we sat in a flock by the embers in our side ease. We pictured the meek, mild creatures where they dwelt in their strawy pen. Nor did it occur to one of us there to doubt they were kneeling then. So fair a fancy few would weave in these years. Yet, I feel, if someone said on Christmas Eve, come, see the oxen kneel in the lonely barton by yonder coombe our childhood used to know, I should go with him in the gloom, hoping it might be so.
Which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart.
Mm-hmm. by Leslie Morris. Out on the windy hill under that southern star, a blaze of radiant light frightened my master. He got up, left our sheep, tramped over the moor, and I, following, came to this open door. Sidled in, settled down, head on my paws, glad to be here away from the wind's sharpness. Such warmth is in this shed, such comfort from this child, that I forgot my hard life, ignore the harsh world, and see on my master's face the same joy I possess, the knowledge of peace, true happiness.
Thank you. Saint John unfolds the great mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
we close, can I thank on all of our behalf Peter and the choir for all of the work they have put into this evening. And thank you too to all who have read to us. On your way out, if you would like to make a donation towards the work of the Children's Society, as you leave, there's a collection plate just by the door. And just to say, when we come to the end of our final hymn, Hark the Herald, if you could briefly lower your mask to blow out your candle, pop your mask back up again before you make your way out. We pray for God's blessing. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the love of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and all whom you love this Christmas time and always. Amen.